Hello, and welcome to this week's coffee vlog. It's Friday the 22nd of May, and we're heading home ready for a long weekend, because it's bank holiday weekend again. And they stick two of these in May, I don't know why. And just like last time, it's just going to mean I've got a short week next week and I'll end up with too much to do and not enough time to get it done again. But hey ho, such is life. So we're heading home ready for the long weekend, and I've got to be honest, this week has been, well, it's been a bit rubbish, to be honest. Not great. Not that the whole year's been that great for me, to be honest. It's been a music loud enough as very distracting, that music, in fact. As the Queen would have said, it's been an annus horribilis. Not been a great year, but on the upside, it can only get better, that's for sure. So, what's been happening this week? New Windows 10 build, hooray, which is 10,122. So that merely went and installed itself fully. Great stuff. But slightly annoyingly, what they've actually done is they're kind of, well, certainly for me, they've made a complete mess of the start menu button thing. I don't know whether this is just them messing about with different ideas and concepts through the beta builds, which, you know, in a way kind of makes sense, because if you're going to do betas and test stuff out, you need to try new and different things. But yeah, they've made it really weird now. So the start menu, the last few builds they had it so those tiled apps that they're now throwing in as part of your normal start menu where you can choose your programs and whatever else. Previously, you could resize it into two sizes, so you had a small one with your small start menu bar, and then they made it so you could resize it and kind of filled the whole screen then, but you slide your programs and whatever else and shut down on the side, but then the tiled things could fill full screen. And now what they've done is they've kind of made it one size, but it's like a block of them that scrolls up and down. But all your programs and apps and shutdown and everything else is hidden away to the side. And you've just got these like three lines at the top left. And if you click them, that kind of pops out and it shows you all your programs and whatever else. But then if you go to have that open and you go back to your live tiles and click on a live tile, it has to hide that bit first before it'll actually do anything with the live tiles. And it's all in one big bar. Not really that keen on it, so I hope that disappears. Might actually be that you can rearrange that somewhere in a setting and that I haven't looked for yet, because I've only had the update a couple of days now, I think, something like that. Also, I got an introduction when opening the application formerly known as Project Spartan, that it was now called The Edge. Microsoft The Edge browser. So I'm not sure how that's going to get on with you too, really, if we'll hear any complaints about them or from them regarding the use of the Edge name. But yeah, so other than that, I'm not really sure if there's anything else new in it, but that it's got a name now, apparently, the new browser. I believe there's actually a logo to go with it. I had a quick look up, but I'm certainly not getting that in the taskbar at the moment. Still got the strange Globy logo that it always had, so shall see about that anyway. But otherwise, yeah, it's still going well. Windows 10, for the most part. They've done some other little enhancements now. I've noticed it started asking me which application I prefer to use to open lots of things, different file types and things, so which is another new bit. So they're generally adding new new little bits and pieces to it. Also, this week, well, actually not this week, but I've been getting on with iOS 8.4 Beta 3 more. Interesting thing, I've been kind of looking up on it more, is iTunes Radio. And I recall, I mentioned, in the first 8.4 Beta, there was actually a little iTunes Radio tab popped up in the new music application. Because obviously they're revamping music for 8.4. So this little iTunes Radio tab was there, but you clicked on it, it did nothing because it's not released in the UK. And then on subsequent builds, it's not been in at all. It disappeared again. Or no, just realised it shouldn't be in because you can't get iTunes Radio in the UK at the moment. Now, I don't know, with the WWDC on the 8th of June, we're going to see, obviously, lots of new application features and whatever else, and it is suggested that this might be one thing that we see a launch of, which is either iTunes Radio for the UK, finally, because it's been long awaited, if they're going to do that, but there are also rumours that maybe Apple, with the Beats acquisition, are going to go for something like a Beats music service instead. So rather than sticking with the iTunes Radio, which is already available in America, been in well over a year, it launched fairly quickly over there, but obviously the problem with these things is Apple have got to negotiate the rights with all the record labels, and it's a bit of a nightmare. They've got to do it for every sort of region and country and whatever else, so that seems to be what's supposedly holding up, is sorting out the UK rights to music streaming and whatever else. But yes, they're perhaps wondering whether they're doing like a Beats radio service. I don't know whether that would perhaps favour the record labels more because of the Beats brand or whatever else. But so we'll have to see about that. I mean, not really sure as far as iTunes Radio goes. I'm not sure what I would use it that much anyway. I don't know if I'm missing out. I mean, there's various apps you can download for doing streaming of radio stations if you want to, whatever else. So, and I'm just not really sure what it's going to be like, but it'll be interesting to see if we do get something like that for WWDC. And, well, that was marvellous. The videos app just crashed completely, I think. Video photos app, recording the video I'm talking to you on, just crashed totally. So I'll have to edit that little bit back in at some point. No idea what went on there. Has been actually pretty stable for me, the photos and video app. So. It's a bit unusual, but who knows, anything can happen with software. So yeah, bank holiday weekend, I did forget to mention entirely after the last one, because the last one was at the start of the month, and the Monday was actually a big day in the geek world anyway, because it was May the 4th be with you, so Star Wars Day, and it was Star Wars Day on Disney XD, which is one of the cable channels. Well, we watch it on Virgin Media anyway. Catch up on a lot on, because that's what's had Star Wars Rebels on. Although I've got all of the episodes stored away anyway. But yeah, they had Star Wars Day. Lots of the Star Wars themed episodes of the sort of cartoony shows and things. And they also had a big trailer for the next season of Star Wars Rebels. And I was a big fan of the first one, cartoon series. Great fun for my 5-year-old, obviously. But as a big kid myself, I really enjoyed it. But I sneakily suspect I liked it more than he did. Because I'll more happily rewatch them than he will in some cases. But yeah, so they had a sneak preview for the next season of Star Wars Rebels, which looked really good. Bringing in more characters from earlier, which really accounts to the Clone Wars cartoons that they did, which were really good. There's an extensive back catalogue for the Clone Wars itself. So, but they're bringing in people into it from, you know, I think that we're going to see some of the actual clones from earlier. It's going to be quite interesting to see how it comes out. It fits itself in between the sort of time. It's 5 years, or well, supposed to be 5 years before the three original episodes of Star Wars, but after number three in the series, which obviously you had one, two and three, and then the first one started 4, 5 and 6. So, and this kind of goes between the two, so the three latest ones, which were actually the first ones, and then the oldest ones, it's just before the oldest ones. So it, in a way, it will sort of catch up with the original ones eventually. It has a lot of the features of the earlier ones, as in the earlier numbered Star Warses, but made more recently. It's very confusing, isn't it? I don't know how someone came up with all this. I wonder if they got confused themselves when they're writing all the gubbins to go with it. So yes, it sort of fits in there, and it's gonna be quite interesting, I think, to see how this next season pans out, and if it starts feeding into, because I wonder if it will actually cross over into the like the original film, so we'll start to see the original film characters in Star Wars Rebels, obviously in cartoon form, not real life, but that'll be interesting. We'll see about that anyway. So and on the subject of cartoons as well, I do watch a lot with having a 5-year-old. I do find them quite entertaining, actually. But also, my youngest has got really into it, and it's quite an interesting series of cartoons. It's called 7D, which it kind of masks what you'd expect it to be. It's about actually seven dwarves, and it's like a cartoon series, but it's a. That's about the fact that there's seven drawers in it is about the limit of how it's got anything to do with what you would think of seven dwarves. So it's called 7D, and it is these seven dwarves, and then there is a princess or a queen, and yeah, basically it's just really, really amusing, very funny. And what they get up to. And it's another one, I think I've been enjoying watching it more than my youngest has, really. So it's on YouTube. If you want to check it out, you can do. 7D, and it is really funny. Right, I've made it home, so I'm going to call it a day now. Have a great bank holiday weekend, and I'll catch you next week with some more and exciting news.